I am Thomas Langen, CEO of Delta Minerals, a Swedish company who's operating in the Philippines. And I have the great pleasure to introduce our new board member and our president in the Philippines, who yesterday was elected to the Swedish board and now is here to make a presentation about our activities in the Philippines. Delta Mineral is a company on Aktietorget, and we've been listed since last year. And by that, I give the word to Mr. Casido. Please.
If you remember, I was here roughly about a year ago presenting what we would like to do in the Philippines and making our promise to make this project in the Philippines a go. Now, just a little more than a year, I mean, just a little more than a month when I came from here, a group from the investors and stockholders from Sweden came over to visit us in the Philippines and, in fact, witnessed the inauguration of our plant, which was put into operation barely only about a month after it was approved. Now it is just a little bit more than a year since that time, and I am here again to present to you the accomplishments of Delta Minerals in as far as the business in the Philippines are concerned. As Thomas earlier mentioned, I am Cornelio Casido. I am a professional mining engineer. I am the president of Delta Global Pacific, a Philippine subsidiary whose name has been recently changed to Delta Environmental Projects Incorporated. And the name of the mother company in Sweden is now also in the process of being renamed into environmental projects similar to what they have in the Philippines. Yes, as we all know, we have this environmental remediation and rehabilitation project of the Cagayan River in the Philippines. Cagayan River, as I have mentioned last year, is one of the three largest and longest and the oldest rivers in the Philippines. Okay. Here is a map of the northern part of the Philippines, which will show you the location of Cagayan River. This Cagayan River starts from Apure going up. It actually encompasses three large watersheds and incorporating three regions north of the Philippines. Okay, here is the closer view of Cagayan River as it ends towards the Babuyan Channel, the South China Sea. This town is a city called Apure, which is the northernmost city of the Philippines. Okay. And this is the river. And our existing dredging and sand processing operation is just located just right here. It's just roughly about 8 miles, nautical miles, to the sea. Here's a closer view of the river. As you can see, the river bed is already heavily silted. In addition to the siltation, you will notice the heavy scouring of the river banks. Okay? And our government came up with a solution. They came up with the Cagayan River Rehabilitation Framework Plan. It's a 25-year government infrastructure project that started in 2010 and hopefully to be finished in the year 2035. The purpose of this framework plan is to protect the river, Cagayan River, from further environmental deterioration. Number two, to restore the river navigation advantage. Historically, Chinese vessels coming from mainland China who would bring goods to the Philippines, they would use this river to bring Chinese goods up to the upstream of Cagayan River to the provinces of Benguet, Mountain Province, and Isabela. Also, the economic, commercial, and agro benefits of the rehabilitation will definitely go down to the province of Cagayan. Cagayan Province is one of the largest agricultural centers of our country. They produce as many products as you can, like rice, tobacco, corn, and other root crops that are exported to other countries. Very recently, Delta Minerals entered into a memorandum of agreement with the local government. And this memorandum agreement was meant to implement the framework plan that was established by our government. By implementing this memorandum of agreement, Delta was able to secure all the necessary permits and licenses. The most important, of course, is the dredging permit, which is the ISAG, industrial sand and gravel permit, and together with the ISAG, its corresponding environmental compliance certificate. Okay? And together with that, because after we dredge the river, we need to process the material so that we can produce the sand that is exactly meeting the requirements of Singapore. Correspondingly, we have to recover, we have to remove the magnetite, iron materials that are also included in the sand. So we have to put up a processing plant. Correspondingly, we have to secure the permit of the plant and its environmental compliance certificate, because now it's a very strict law in our country. For every industry, for every operation, you have to secure or establish, you have to secure an environmental compliance certificate. It's a system that our country adopted here in European Union, because this actually emanated from Europe. Now, this is the dredge machine that we acquired from the previous operator. As far as I can remember, this is the largest dredging machine I know of in our country. It has a capacity of 700 cubic meters per hour, and it can go down to as deep as 20 meters from the surface of the river. Okay. This is another view of the dredge machine, and you can notice the pontoons, the floaters, where the pipeline emanates from the dredge machine all the way to the area where we have the processing plant. The earlier operators of the area, who were interested only on the magnetite sand, were able to accumulate a waste stockpile of sand up to 200,000 tons right there sitting beside the plant, okay? And they were having problems on how to dispose this sand, because it's a requirement under their ECC. They were very lucky because Mr. Hokan came right time in the right place. They were looking for sand to supply to Singapore. And when we acquired the rights to operate the area, we have the already stockpiled 200,000 tons, and Delta authorized us to do a continuing exploration. And we were able to establish additional reserves of 2 billion tons and additional measured reserves of 500,000 tons. Altogether, we have in that area a total of 2 billion tons of material. And it has a grade of average of 3% iron in situ, in place. Okay, so if we have to recover the iron, okay, the 3% will be increased to as much as 55%. Okay. Here's a typical characteristic of the sand as we take it from the river. We have classified them according to sizes, which fits exactly the specifications of the reclamation sand of Singapore, and by weight and the actual contents of the material as we dredge it from the river. Here's a picture of what we are doing right now. Here is the existing plant that we have that is now actually on full commercial operation. And over the next few years, 3 years for that to be exact, we envision to put up additional 3 more plants. Altogether, Delta will be producing a total of 1.5 million tons per year of sand production. Now, you might want to know why it is 1.5 million tons. Until about 3 years ago, no sand was being taken from the Philippines for Singapore. All the reclamation sand in Singapore were coming from Myanmar, Indonesia, Vietnam, as far as Thailand. But very recently, last year, the Association of ASEAN Countries decided to allocate some of the requirements of Singapore to be coming from the Philippines, because of only one reason. The mining of sand in those countries has ended up into heavy environmental damage. Okay, because for example in Vietnam, until today they have no environmental laws yet, and it is a pity that the local areas, especially in Burma and in Cambodia, are being destroyed and no way of rehabilitating them. Unlike in the Philippines, we have a very strict law on environmental management. You will notice this is a channel that we want to do so that the big boats from Singapore will come directly to our plants. Okay? And this is intended to accommodate the Panamax boats. Panamax would carry a minimum of 50,000 tons per load. Okay? The material that we get out of the channel is exactly the same material that we'll be processing and loading it directly to the foreign vessels. Without this channel, we will be having the foreign vessels at bay, and then we will barge the material to the vessels. It will be very, very expensive. And this kind of business, as we all know, is a logistics intensive business. So we will make money on the matter of how we make logistics simpler, faster, and a lot cheaper. So this concept that we have envisioned and we have engineered is the best way we know that we can be very competitive with those coming from Vietnam. This is the first plant that Delta Minerals has established in the area. This is a plant, some of you here were in the Philippines last year. This is the plant that you saw, the very old plant, and within a very short time, we were able to convert it into a sand plant. It used to be a magnetite plant. Now we are able to convert it into a sand plant that will produce sand that fits exactly the specifications of Singapore. Okay, so now, since we are looking at four plants in the future, we call it the Delta Sand Plant Number One. It's Delta Plant Number One. This plant has been fitted now by Delta with a number of hydrocyclones that are installed at Ceres. The hydrocyclones are a special kind of machines, as I presume everybody of us know, a special machines that can size the material very fast at high capacity. It could be done by screening, by breathing screen, but it's very slow and very inefficient. Plus, it's very expensive to operate the vibrating screens. But with these hydrocyclones, we are able to produce massive volumes of sand according to the specs. I mean, this one cyclone will produce a special kind of sand, special size. The other cyclone also another size. Okay. So what happens is that, I think you saw this when you were there, in our yard is a number of stockpiles of various sizes. Okay. We operate like a pharmacy, you know, how you call it in Europe, a apothec, yeah. The pharmacy produce stockpiles of various chemicals, and the pharmacist will make the composition of the medicine out of this. Exactly what we are doing here, we have various sizes of stockpiles, and whoever will give us an order, whether it's from China, from Singapore, or from Japan, or even locally, we can just select whatever we have in the stockpile and deliver it according to the specifications. Then that's the way we can be very competitive. Here's a picture of our operations. These are now the local people, formerly fishermen, who are because this river is a very big area for fishing. These people that we have used to be fishermen, and Delta actually spent some investments on training them from fishermen to plant operators. In fact, some of them are now supervisors here. Okay, here's now a stockpile of the final product of the sand after it has gone through the processing. Okay. And here is also a stockpile of finished product sand that has been stockpiled right beside the river. So if we now start selling this abroad, all we need to do is dock the barges in the river and load the sand directly to the barges. This can carry barges with capacities up to 3,000 tons per load. Okay. Then we bring it out to the sea where we have the Panamax loading there. Okay, here's also another picture. Here is the sand. Okay, And the black one is the magnetite sand. Okay, we have, if you will notice, the magnetite has been stockpiled in a manner that it has a concrete flooring, concrete walls, because these are far more expensive than the sand. We have to take care of it from contamination, from dilution, okay? So that we do not diminish the value because of dilution. Okay, here is the analysis, as analysis of our market for magnetite sand, done by Sand Globe of Hong Kong, and it was analyzed in China. You will notice that the grade of iron as it is in the plant is already 54%, and the marketable value, marketable grade, is at least about 55%. Okay, we can actually bring it all the way to 61%, but of course we have to match the cost of high grading or the cost of producing high grade material against the price of magnetite. Okay, this is also a very important aspect of our operation, wherein we show you here how we handle our wastewater. In some operations, from the plant, it just goes straight to the river. But we are governed by our environmental compliance certificate that before we let go of the water to the river, we pass them through a series of decant. Okay, come from here, then decant. By the time it goes to the river, it's already as clear as possible, as clear as and as clean as what we have in the river. So you see, we put them here, then get it for the sand, then allow them to decant. In the process, towards the end, we have a big sump where we collect all the water, because this water now contains the very fine material. We call it slimes. Okay? We allow them to settle, and then it will overflow straight to the river. Then we collect the slimes, and this is now a stockpile of these slimes. Okay? I will explain to you later the importance and the economic significance of slime, why we want to collect it, other than preventing it from going to the river. But we have a project that was nominated to us, a very big World Bank that nominated this project to us. This is a picture that's very close to my heart. Also the bishop of the church. The bishop in our area is the number one anti-mining. But he is our friend now, because we were able to prove to him that Delta Minerals, the Delta process, number one, does not use a drop of any chemicals in the process to recover magnetite. Secondly, we demonstrate to them that our processed water is as clean and can be actually used as drinking water for the buffaloes. Okay? This is a picture that we get every morning and every afternoon. Okay? And this bishop got a picture of this. As a matter of fact, he had it displayed in his office. One time I was in his office and he showed me a very big picture of Delta Minerals with its processed water being displayed as a clean water.
And they are still alive.
Oh yeah, of course, of course. Yeah, they are still alive. These buffaloes are actually used by farmers in the farm. Okay. And some of them, through the efforts of Delta, we are helping them, coming from one agency of our government, how to get milk from the buffaloes. Okay, like what you have here in Europe, the cattle. They don't do that in the Philippines, but now with the help of our government, we are helping the farmers to get milk and produce cheese out of it. Okay, we have, over the 1 year that we have started operations, we have established our market commitments. For magnetite, we have signed up with Sun Globe Corporation of Hong Kong for the delivery of magnetite to China. Okay. We also signed up with a company, Golden Kingdom Limited, that sends magnetite to China and also sends magnetite to India. Because Golden Kingdom actually is a company owned by both Chinese and businessman from India. The reclamation sand, we have a contract with Cahaya Limited of Singapore. Cahaya Limited is the largest supplier of sand to Jurong. Jurong is the city in Singapore that is now implementing this reclamation projects. Cahaya has an advantage because Cahaya, as of today, has 7 Panamax boats. 7 Panamax boats. That's why it is very competitive to them to pick up our sand, okay, and at the least possible expense, they can deliver it to Singapore anytime. It will take only 2 days from our plant to Singapore. Okay, unlike we bring it to China, it takes about a week. Construction Sand is also Heritage Resources, which is a local company that manufactures this pre-stressed concrete that are used in the construction and rebuilding of Manila in nearby cities. Right now, our government, because of the anticipated change in government, our government is now pushing hard with infrastructures. When you were there, they just started the skyways. Now, most of the skyways are all done now, and they're expanding the skyways to other parts of Metro Manila. And of course, the slime materials, brick factory. This brick factory happened to be nominated to us by a European guy working with the Asian Development Bank. He's a German national, a friend of Mr. Hawken, because he said, brick factory fits very well your material. And you know, ADB, Asian Development Bank, promotes businesses that directly benefits the local communities. Okay, here is a picture that is also one of my favorites. This is the picture that we took when Sunglobe, our market for magnetite, handed the first check of our magnetite sand. Okay. I happened to be there and witnessed the giving of the check. This is the president of Sunglobe, and this is Miss Gloria Benson, a director of the company, also our finance guy, and our cashier. Okay. So we expect to be able to receive the next check again, hopefully next month, and another one before the end of the year. For the reclamation sand, if you will notice, this is the specs from Singapore, and this is what we produce, actually. And you will notice all of it pass the specs of Singapore. Why? Because when we started building the plant, the guy from Chai actually would visit us in the Philippines and help us calibrate the plant so that we do not miss the specs as specified by the government of Singapore. So it's all passed. Okay? Because we have established that we are able to feasibly operate the plant and produce what is required, we come up now with the next step. We are now looking forward. We are now looking forward, and hopefully within the next 3 years, we should be hitting the final capacity of 1.5 million tons per year. Okay? Right now, we have the old plant. Then hopefully next year, if things will work out with our initiatives for the fundraising, we will have another old plant, another new plant by next year. And then the year after that, we have the second new plant. Hopefully by the time, we will have 3 plants. Okay? Actually, 3 plants. But actually, we have 4 plants, okay? The old one and 3 new ones. But as a normal practice, we always have 1 plant allocated as a spare in case of emergencies. We have to, but out of the 4, we'll have 3 plants running at any one time to produce 1.5 million tons per year. Okay, here is for the construction. Here is one picture how they are now reconstructing Manila. This is the Skyway. And this prefab concrete members fits very well the use of our sand. Okay, these are engineered beams. Okay, I think you saw this when you came to Manila because this is one right in front of the airport. Okay. It's done now. It's being used now. Okay, okay. These prefab materials for girders and concrete beams, yeah. And of course, the skyway girders and the concrete floorings. Okay. So all of these are done outside of the job site and are delivered to the job site for assembly. Okay. For the slimes, we have the materials for perfect for brick factory. Okay. It's a brick and a picture of the extruder. Okay, extruders. And you will believe, I think you also saw this when you were there, buildings made out of bricks. churches made out of bricks, schools made out of bricks. And we would like to promote this, but I'd like to let you know now that when we decided, the board of our company decided to go into this project, we had one thing in mind, of course. Of course, we have to make at least break even. But the underlining purpose is we want to eventually turn it over to the local community. Okay? We want it to be a livelihood for the local people. Because of every 10 men in the community, we can give jobs to 2 or 3. What about the 7 who will be wanting to work also? In fact, you believe that there are workers who are willing to work 1 week and then off for 1 week, then back again. But this time we are doing better. We are creating a livelihood for them to work continuously. In fact, even with this, believe me, even women are willing to work here. Okay. One important advantage of Delta's operation in the area is the employment generation. Okay. With that alone, we already have 330 employment. Okay. Right now, we have 33, including me. Because I'm now in Sweden, there are only 32 that are now working. It does not include those we employed from the brick plant and from the construction sand. And we have 33. In the Philippines, statistics is that for every one employee, it's multiplied by 5 that benefit out of the job. Altogether, Delta's operation in that area would redound to about 1,500 people with direct and indirect employment. Okay? And that is why the local government, the church, even the local people, okay, include, especially now that we are approaching elections, okay, Delta Minerals is like angels. Every day we get guests from these agencies trying to promote us, trying to even campaign for us, okay, that we should do more, stay longer, and make more business out of this. Thank you, and I hope you were able to have a very short idea of what we have accomplished in just 1 year since I was last here. Hopefully, if I will be invited again next year, we'll have the second plant already operating, and we'll be showing to you pictures of our ocean vessels loading and unloading in Singapore. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Roger.